Find any vertical and horizontal asymptotes of the graph of the function f of x equals 2x squared plus x minus 6 all over x squared minus 9. Let's find the vertical asymptotes first. First of all, this denominator cannot be allowed to be equal to 0. Just like with any fraction, 0 in the denominator is undefined. So I'll just write right here, if this denominator equals 0, then you have a vertical asymptote. And by the way, that vertical asymptote, that's, say this is the coordinate plane, the vertical asymptote will be some line. This line is not part of the graph, it's just where the graph will shoot up or shoot down or something like that. Okay, so vertical asymptotes. Let's solve this equation, this x squared minus 9 equals 0. So add 9 to each side and you get x squared equals 9, and take the square root of each side to solve for x. And when you take the square root, you have to say plus or minus. So we have values of x equals plus or minus 3. So I'm going to put way down in the corner here, vertical asymptotes. We just found a couple. And that is x equals negative 3 and x equals positive 3. All right, moving along to the horizontal asymptotes. Now there's not a formula like that to find the horizontal asymptotes, but think about this. Horizontal asymptotes mean that if we go to the left very far or to the right very far, what is this graph going to look like? Or that is, as x gets huge, what is this graph going to look like? Well, as x gets super big, this part won't matter. And this part won't matter. Because 10,000 to the second power, 10,000 squared, is a lot more than just 10,000 and a lot more than negative 6 and this negative 9. So it won't matter. So we're just looking at these leading coefficients. And more appropriately, the leading terms. But then we are going to be looking at the leading coefficients. So let's put a 1 there. So if I have a huge number here, well, it doesn't matter anymore. We've already gotten rid of these because this is a huge number squared, just gets rid of these. So therefore, we have 2x squared over 1x squared. And we can then simplify that, just cross these out. Now, I know this isn't what's really happening in the near case here. We're just talking about really far to the right and really far to the left. Once you cross those out, then you have 2 over 1. So the vertical asymptote then, I'm sorry, the horizontal asymptote will be y equals what is left there, 2 over 1, or just 2. So that line, y equals 2, again, this is not part of the graph, but it's just showing that that's where the graph is going to tend to over time, really far to the right or to the left. All right, so we found our vertical asymptotes and our horizontal asymptotes.